to your grandfather. You're not listening to the elderly.
I have the right to talk.
You're not listening to the experienced. You're not listening to the educated. Can you speak in front of other people for 2 hours, 1 hour? Can you get up on a ladder in speaker's corner and speak?
Well, it depends.
You can't.
It depends what you're talking about. Maybe I don't know about.
Okay, let me invite you. Get a ladder, get a chair, stand up in speaker's corner.
So that makes you better than me? If you speak in front of 1,000 people, a rock star can speak in front of 1,000,000 people. Does that make him better than you?
If you are a Muslim, act like a Muslim.
There's
okay?
A rock star guy. He's talking.
If you are a Muslim,
so he's better than all of us.
I am a Muslim speaker. You don't need to give problem to a Muslim speaker.
What does it mean, Muslim speaker? What do you mean, Muslim speaker? I'm a Muslim as well.
What about you?
Okay. You don't know speaker.
No, the problem is, yeah.
Okay, let me tell you.
Because you have a bag.
This is.
And you wear it like that and you have a book. You think you're better than everyone. That's wrong.
Did I say?
That's how you talk. That's
okay,
talk.
Your beard is better than mine.
Historically. No, that's what.
Now, what do you mean I got a beard and I think. Okay, your beard is mine. Okay, is that beard according to Sunnah?
It is.
Okay. So.
If I don't have it, what does that mean?
Excuse me. Why are you angry?
Well, because.
Did you come from Sham? Did you come from Iraq?
Why keep you angry? I'm loud because it's easy.
Are you Kurdish?
What's that?
Are you Kurdish?
I'm human.
No, are you Kurdish?
I'm human.
Well, you said you are Kurdish. Let me tell you, I am Pakistani, I'm not Turkish. So why are you giving me problem?
I'm not giving you problem, we're having a conversation.
Anyway, we'll carry on. Ladies and gentlemen, as Muslims, we know what Islam is. Allahu Akbar!
You don't know, you only know.
Go on, respect the elders, okay?
I respect you, but you don't respect me.
At home, your father is your elder, respect them.
I respect you as my father.
Well, you respect me, and I'm not your father. If you respect me, then kindly leave me alone. And let me carry on speaking. Jazakallah, may Allah bless you. Yeah? Now we didn't have that argument. Now that youngster, he says as a Muslim, he came here first time.
But
okay, he's got no experience what happens in speaker's corner. And he's trying to tell me how to go about speaking. What he doesn't know is, I have been speaking in speaker's corner since the 1980s. So I was here in the 1980s. I was here in the 1990s. I was here in the 2000 plus decade. I was here in the 2010 plus.
Did I not count enough, sir?
4 decades.
Sorry, sir.
And yet, somebody who comes here first time is telling me how to go about doing things. Sir, you're speaking.
You don't look old enough to say it. It's not credible, that story. You're not old enough.
I'm a father. I am a grandfather.
You don't look old enough. You don't look old enough.
Alhamdulillah, we Muslims are very smart. Now we are old, you know, white beard, but I look young. Why? Alhamdulillah, we follow the Sunnah and we follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is so kind, He makes even old Muslims like me look young. Okay. Now, sir, I'm a Muslim. What do you believe in?
I believe in Jesus.
You gave me about this.
I've been here about half an hour giving that.
Jesus died on the cross and rose from the dead so that I may be forgiven for my sins.
For Jesus.
Spend eternity with my Savior, my God in heaven.
So, excuse me. Did you say Jesus is God?
No, I don't say that. I say Jesus is divine.
When you say Jesus is divine, do you mean Jesus is God? Yes or no?
He has the nature of God.
Okay, so do you mean He is God?
He's fully God and fully man.
Ah, okay. So you told us that Jesus is 100% man. Yes?
Fully God and fully man.
And you said He's 100% God. Now, how can is a man, a human, is a man creation.
He chooses company with creation.
So Jesus was 100% creation.
No, his physical body was 100% creation.
Okay, the body of Jesus, was it 100% creation?
Yes.
Right, now, was Jesus 100% God?
He was fully God and fully man.
How can God be 100% human and 100% God? How?
Why not? Why have a limited God like you do, who can't come to earth? God is limited and he can't come to earth.
Is God the creator?
I believe he's the creator, yes.
Can a man be creator?
Man can be created, yes.
Can a man be creator?
Yes, a man can be created.
Can God die?
Creator.
Oh, sorry, I didn't hear your question. I'm sorry.
Can man be a creator?
Jesus was creator, and he limited himself to be a man, so that he was in a man's body.
www.confused.com
www.limitedgod.com
www.lost.com www.unbelievable.com
Of course it's unbelievable! It's www. You would expect it to be unbelievable!
www.nosense.com Now, this is Speaker's Corner. In Speaker's Corner, you hear a lot. And in Speaker's Corner, you also hear Allahu Akbar. Okay, excuse me.
Allah limited. Allah's limited. If you actually understand the Quran, you see he's really limited.
No. Okay.
Have you done any research in this topic?
Do you as a Christian believe in your Bible? Are you running away? Come on. Are you wanted? Are you wanted? Are you a coward? Look at the Muslim, I'm standing in front of camera. No worry. Why are you scared? Come on. Are you a Christian or a coward? Did you say you stand for the truth? Okay, Mr. Christian, we Muslims, our Quran, Allahu Akbar.
Quran is a lie.
Hey, you're a liar, quiet. One Christian at a time. Hey, we Muslims, Allahu Akbar. Stop crying. You're shaitan. Behave yourself. Okay, you're grown up. You're behaving like a small baby. Allah, even babies are manners. Not these Christians. www.confused.com. Anyway, Allahu Akbar. You're shaitan. Anyway, excuse me. Mr. Christian, how many books in your Bible? Knockout question. How many books in your Bible? Our Quran. 140 surah chapters. Our Quran, 80,000 words. Our Quran, more than 300,000 letters. Our Quran, more than 600 verses. Our Quran, anywhere is the same Quran. Your Bible, his Protestant Bible, 66 books. His Catholic Bible, 73 books. So is your Bible true or is his Bible true? How that Christian has run away. You can film him, he's running away. Okay, it got too hot for him. No answers. Okay, anyway. Okay, stand over there. Are you a Christian or a coward? Stand there. Stand there. Okay. How many books in your Bible? This Christian said it doesn't matter. Does the Bible matter, yes or no? Right. Now, how many books in your Bible? Doesn't matter. Let me tell you. In your Catholic Bible, 73 books. Is that the true Bible? So, is the Protestant Bible with 66 books, is that the wrong Bible? It's true. So how comes Protestant Bible 66 books, Catholic Bible 73 books? How can they be? Why different number of books? So the Christian says it doesn't matter how many books in his Bible. Can you imagine? He says the Bible is the book of God. But when I ask him how many books in his Bible, he says it doesn't matter. Next question. If the Bible is a book of God, does the Bible as a book of God matter? It matters, right? Is everything in your Bible true?
Yes.
This Christian says yes. Okay. Now, in the Christian Bible, in any Christian Bible, in the book of Acts, chapter 2, verse 22, the Christian Bible says, Jesus of Nazareth was a man. The Bible says, any Bible. Bible says, Jesus of Nazareth was a man sent by God to you to do miracles, wonders, and signs which God did among you through him.